coverage you can count on.
Glasses moving on their own, shadows darting from room to room, and a cowboy who doesn't like anyone near his bar stool.
These are stories of reported hauntings at the Cuchillo Bar. Action 7 News reporter Anna Velasquez tagged along with paranormal investigators to see if these stories were true.
Can you make a sound?
During the investigation of the old Cuchillo Bar,
to let us know that you're here,
we got the feeling we were being watched.
Oh, you saw a shadow.
And maybe we were. That's a disembodied voice, or EVP, captured on a digital recorder. It sounds like the same chilling voice the team captured in the bar back in 2009. Only that time, it swore at lead investigator Steve Compeer.
In life, you hear these bad words, but to hear it from some disembodied voice at the time is a little more unsettling.
Steve happened to be standing over the middle bar stool, setting his camera up. Was this the voice of the cowboy others have seen, possessive about the middle bar stool? During that same investigation, Steve's son Andy sat in that seat.
Do you want me to get up out of your chair so you can sit down?
Built in the 1800s, the Cuchillo Bar and Store became the hub for the village. Over the years, it served as a post office, saloon, a stagecoach station, and even a hotel. Before that, it was a favorite Apache hunting ground. Property owner Josh Bond tries to ignore the unexplained.
Trust me, I look for any excuse to not have the paranormal happen.
So he opens up the place to paranormal investigators who try to catch evidence of paranormal activity. Steve Compeer has more than 20 years experience.
We try to verify and validate through electronic means, whether it be cameras.
Show yourself.
Digital audio.
Can you make a sound to let us know that you're here?
Photography. And even personal experiences.
That's some cool air.
There was no shortage of personal experiences during this investigation. We saw twinkling orbs of light in the back room of the bar.
What was that from?
And smelled a sweet scent.
It's like right here.
That vanished as quickly as it came. We also used what's called a spirit box. A modified radio that rapidly sweeps through frequencies believed to enable a spirit to talk through the white noise.
Can you see us?
Steve and his team always try to find a logical explanation for what happens, and when they can't debunk it, well, that's when it falls into the unexplained category.
I don't get scared at investigation. I find it more interesting that there is something more to our existence here. What that existence is, I don't know. I find the off chance of actually seeing objects move on their own, seeing random lights, that's fascinating.
In Cuchillo, I'm Ana Velasquez, KOAT, Action 7 News.
The team also looks into homes around the state where frightened residents ask for help. And-